Okay, so good morning. So in the last class, we discussed the Poisson's equation and we proved a set of, I won't call it as theorems, proved a set of equations or relations which are going to be very useful in our study of atmospheric thermodynamics. Okay, the first was that the theta is okay from initial temperature of T to P. If you adiabatically expand or compress to a standard pressure of 1000 hPa, the temperature which the air parcel finally takes is the potential temperature. Then what is this reversible in adiabatic? We are just having a quick 3-minute recap of whatever we did yesterday. Okay, reversible. Adiabatic is the heat transfer is 0, okay. That is one of the assumptions in the air parcel also, it is adiabatic. Reversible means it is reversible, that means the process can be reversed. If you take a piston cylinder arrangement, if you compress it from position A to position B, it is possible for you to expand it from B to A, okay. So by definition a reversible process is very slow, fast process cannot be generally reversed. So we call it as a quasi-static process, okay. If a balloon is there filled with air, you take a pin and prick it, then the air comes out, it is an instantaneous process, it is irreversible because if you assume that the work done in pricking is almost 0, okay, then there is no work done involved in the process, there is a inflated balloon which has got air inside, you just prick the balloon, then the air went out. Now you have a deflated balloon. You go to the fellow who does your cycle puncture, close that hole, try inflating it again, you cannot do it without some work. This is the concept of reversibility. So this balloon pricking, which is a fast process, is irreversible. So many processes, if the irreversible means irreversible in time, we cannot reverse it. Irreversible, generally in the context of time we say, in thermodynamics irreversible means we cannot trace it back without some change either in the system or the surroundings or both, okay. So reversible in adiabatic, somebody said it is also called isentropic, okay. It is isentropic, but since we have not introduced entropy, I didn't want to mention, but since all of you are, there is no need to feign ignorance, let us say this, you all know this, so, but I promise that we will revisit this and do the second law after some classes, isentropic. Okay. So lines joining points with constant pressure are called isobars. Lines joining points with constant temperatures are isotherms. Okay. Lines joining points in a heat transfer problem with same heat flux are called isoflux. Lines joining points in a map which receive the same rainfall are called isobar. Surrender. Same rainfall. They are called isohyets. If you study optimization, if there is an objective function which is profit, if you join lines having same profit, they are called isoprofit lines. If you join points having the same cost, your optimization problem is a function of x1, x2, x3 and x4. x1, x2, x3, x4 are your variables and y is the constant, y is your cost, y equal to y1, y equal to y2. If you have joined these lines, these are called iso cost lines. So if it is a cost, it is iso cost. If it is profit, it is iso profit, iso efficiency, iso break thermal efficiency. If you put it in the parameter space, you plot it. So generally you can call them as iso objective contours. Okay, like that we can have a class on ISO for 1 hour, but now that is not central to our discussion here. So, we will get back to this. So, for a reversible and adiabatic process, we proved that theta is conserved. Theta is conserved means what? Theta remains the same throughout. Okay? So, we already proved that if you have got P1 V1 to the power of gamma, no, from P1 V1, it is going to P2 V2, and the root is this. You are taking this root, then the theta 1 and the theta 2 are nothing but this. This we proved in yesterday's class. Then we solved a very interesting problem of a what is that? Air outside the cabin, 250 HPa, okay, minus 50 degree centigrade. Okay. Now I am doing an on the spot innovation. Problem number. Problem number 23. The previous one was 22, no? What a dumb question. The 22 was the aircraft problem?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Revisit the aircraft air. Revisit the aircraft cabin air problem. Revisit the aircraft cabin air problem. Revisit the aircraft cabin air problem, whatever. Or revisit problem 22. B. What is that? This is 23.
Yeah,
revisit 22B. Revisit 22B. Very good. Okay, it looks like something in which you argue in the court of law. Revisit 22B. Determine the height at which the plane is flying. Determine the height at which the plane is flying. Don't ask me what is the scale height, you know, you are all already done 1.5 months of atmospheric science, more than 1 month, 1.5 months. Some scale height, you will use 8 kilometer or 7.5? 7.5, 8, whatever. In the quiz also, if you use 7.5 or 8, I will give marks. No, don't worry. I will start looking at the papers today. I have already worked out the solutions. Okay. So, you will assume that P naught is some 1000, right? Z2 minus Z1 is, you do that, e to the power of minus, no, P minus P naught, we will use that. This is also okay. This comes from hydrostatics, right? So 250 either minus, watch out, Z is in kilometers now. Yeah, please tell me Z equal to 1 meter is 3.3 feet. Yeah. What will this be? Thirty-four thousand. Okay. So commercial jetliners fly at an altitude of 30,000 to 40,000 feet. Okay. For example, the B787 Dreamliner is actually 787-800. Okay. It is also called B788. Boeing 787 Dreamliner 800 series. Now 787-900 series is going to come. 787-1000 series is going to come. Okay, so the service ceiling is 43,100 feet. If you go above that, if you take the air from outside, compress this thing, and already it is very low, right? 250 hp. If you go to 43,000, we can actually work it out, but then it's not central to our. Okay, sir, will it not be brilliant idea if the planes fly at 1,000 or 2,000 feet so that we can avoid all crashes? What is the answer? What is the answer to that question? Why are planes flying at 35,000, 40,000? No traffic there, or? Why is it? Yes, it is more economical. Why? Drag is very less, because what will be the density of air? So the viscous drag is very less. So they will do this, right? Okay, so I think they will take off, climb, cruise, descent, and it's approach and landing. So they require the full throttle power for this, okay, a reasonable amount of power for this. Then at cruise, they will reduce the throttle. Then they will do it further, and then. But then when they are landing, they should be at the same condition as takeoff, because any emergency they should be able to take off again. So landing is not, sir. Why can't we land at 10 kilometer, 20 kilometer? It will stall, lead to accident. So what is the typical landing speed of a 788? Or Boeing 737. Takeoff and landing speed? 250 to 300 kilometers. They will reduce it to 250 or 2. Sometimes when they do all these maneuvers and the speed decreases so much, if you have traveled many times, you will know that as he approaches the runway, he will again increase the speed to prevent the stall. Then you will think, what, did he go nuts? Why is he doing that? Because he has to be at that condition. If he is too fast, then he will do what is called a go around. He will come and then again he will go. Once you do that, half an hour is gone. Then he will have to climb and this thing, air traffic control, clearance, there will be other, you will be in a sequence. Then you will do what is called chakkar. You will do this, and then you will get the permission, and then sometimes, now it is not happening, sometimes you can just approach, the ATC will see that you have not deployed your gear, because something happened. Okay, if you are not deployed your wheel, ATC will say, hey, it has happened in Chicago and all. Then you go around. Then either there is problem or he simply slept or he simply forgot. But nowadays it's all piloting for dummies. So it will say, it will just go on beeping, deploy gear, or it will deploy automatically at 2500 feet. Okay, so it will, but most of the landings are now instrument, it's guided with a computer. But in order to preserve the skill set, sometimes they switch to manual. So that they don't lose their skills. Can we use the pseudo, can we use a chart or a thermodynamic diagram to understand this better? and can we solve this problem using an pseudo-adiabatic chart. You got a sneak peek of this on the television already, but we'll go through, I'll just tell you the theory behind this diagram and how we can use this diagram to solve this. So the next 20 minutes or so, I'll just explain what are the coordinates of this diagram. Then I'll give you one copy of the chart. You will revisit problem 22A, B, 23, whatever. You will solve the same problem using the pseudo-adiabatic chart. Then you will find out the difference between your computation which you did yesterday and this. That is because of the approximations. And then we will see what are the disadvantages in this chart and what is the next step forward, what will be a better chart. Is that okay? Fine. The Poisson's equation, what is the Poisson's equation? I already told you. If I not formally stated this, this is the Poisson's equation. The equation for potential temperature theta is called the Poisson's equation. Can be conveniently solved using charts. Of course, when you use a chart, approximation will be there. As usual, because charts are easier to use, it is widely used in meteorology. Which is widely used in meteorology? Such kinds of charts, okay? Now, is it possible to, I will sit down. Let's try this. Now, okay. So, this is what is called the pseudo-adiabatic chart, okay. The pseudo-adiabatic chart has got pressure. Where is the pseudo-adiabatic chart? No, no, not this one. Yes, yes, I want to write down this. Okay. So, so this is the pseudo-adiabatic chart where the pressure is the ordinate and temperature is the absolute. Why did that line come? Okay. So pressure is the ordinate and temperature is the abscissa. Okay. So isotherms are straight line joining temperature points having same temperature. What a dumb answer. On the pseudo-adiabatic chart, isotherms are on the pseudo-adiabatic chart, isotherms are vertical lines. Please write down. On the pseudo-adiabatic chart, isotherms are vertical lines. Isobars are horizontal lines. Okay, now how do I let this be there? How do I make you believe that these theta lines are like this sloping downwards? So let us start working out the math, right? So we already saw this pressure, isobars are like this, and it is somewhat log scale, right? Pressure, temperature is linear scale, and 0 to 400 is the range of temperature which you usually encounter. Okay, I am switching to the blackboard again. Now, theta for theta equal to constant, C equal to okay. So T equal to C into okay. So T is an exponent can be related to the log. So this is pressure. So this is the equation of a constant theta line. So a constant theta line will be a line which is sloping downwards. They are oriented at an acute angle relative to the isotherms. Okay, so sir, why are you saying pseudo adiabatic? It is pseudo adiabatic because we are not considering moist air, we are considering dry air. So the actual adiabatic will come tomorrow. So now this is because it's assuming we are assuming mass of water vapor is zero right now. We have to introduce that. So if you have to introduce that, it is not so straightforward. I have to tell you what is mixing ratio, what is specific humidity, what is relative humidity, what is saturation pressure, vapor pressure. We have to get deeper into moist air thermodynamics. Okay, that is actually like psychrometry. Okay, in mechanical engineering. So pseudo adiabatic chart, constant theta lines. Are okay. What is so there is something very peculiar about this chart. What is that? Y axis, the 1000 is down and 0 is up. Please note, 1000 is here. So 1000 is here. Are you? Okay, 0 is here. It is connecting this. So let me try something. These are the art of messing up a tablet PC. Okay. All right. So the theta lines are, I think I need to train up. The theta lines are sloping downwards. Okay. Now there is some region indicated here. Okay, this region, what is special about the region? Green color. No, that's because I use some ink. What is special about that region? not comfort. That is the region where we are interested in atmospheric science. That is the region of interest in atmospheric science. Now, the funda is, the isotherm is like this. Yes. And the dry adiabat is like this. Very close. They are very close. It is very confusing. So, it is not a very good chart for use, but it can be used with limitation. This is overcome by what is called a skew T ln P chart. Okay. What is the problem? So, difficult to use. So, the next chart which people have developed is called the skew T ln P chart. Okay. Before we go to the skew T ln P chart, now, so problem number 20, problem 24, solve problem 22 using the pseudo adiabatic chart. Solve problem 22 using the pseudo adiabatic chart. Compare your solution with that obtained before. Solve problem 22 using the pseudo adiabatic chart. Compare the solution of, compare the solution with that obtained before. This both parts A and B, okay. So, in the quizzes and exam, I leave it to you, whichever is convenient, you can either use the formula or the chart. Which will be more accurate? Yes, formula is more accurate, but which is fast? But this log is a problem, okay. So, if you want to use it repeatedly, I mean, if you, there are many computations to perform, chart may be a little bit advantageous. Using the pseudo adiabatic chart. Okay. So, P1 The question is like this, outside air is 250 hpa and minus 50 degree centigrade, 223 Kelvin, what is the potential temperature theta? Not using the formula, but the formula which has been replaced or replaced by a chart or a diagram, it is a chart. Then this air is then compressed. Why is it compressed? Whenever pressure increases, it is called compressed. Okay. So, from 250, it is becoming 850. We want to know the corresponding temperature. You already know the solution, theta and T2 from yesterday's class. Now, some interpolation you have to do. Have you done it already? Please do it now. Then I will show it there. Yes. Shall we start? Yeah, yeah. Where is this now? 250 and 223. Is this line? Okay. That that is rigging. It's okay. 250. Something. So, that is. Oh, what happened? Went off. It erased the whole thing. Okay, this is. That is outside air. I realize that it is not suited for my speed. It has to be treated with respect. 250 hp minus 50. Now please help me. I don't know how to.
Wait, is there a scale?
Now this is really tough. What is the theta now? We have to look at some theta which is in this. Then we will don't say that the theta is the same as what we got in yesterday's class. Yeah, you just interpolate. Now, theta is? 331. You are having 6/1 vision. What is it? Approx. 330 is okay. 330, yeah. Okay. 330 Kelvin. Now, this is expanded, compressed. Compressed means you are going down in the pseudo-adiabatic chart. Expanded means you are going up. Up. What is the root? You have to follow the root of constant theta. Okay. If you follow the straight line, it is basically isotherm. If you go horizontally, it is isobar. That sloping line going downwards is adiabatic. Very good. So, now, there is no scale, but still we will manage. We have to go to 850, na? First, you have to draw the. I will try something now. It's 850, yeah? So, this is called the IIT way of doing things. Okay. Yes, what is that? 320. What did you get yesterday?
360.
Okay. Not bad. If you get 316, I will cut mark. 3? Fine. Very good. Okay. So, this problem also erased. That does not matter. So, this is the way to solve a problem with the pseudo-adiabatic chart. Okay. Shall we proceed to the next one? Now your the problem is, as I already told you, these are very close. This vertical and the, not the vertical and the horizontal, they are far off. The vertical and the sloping theta lines are very close, and everything may be get cluttered up. You can't get clarity when multiple processes are there. Here just one process. When the cloud is, air parcel is going up, it is condensing, it is coming down, and the wind is blowing, and you want to represent all this. You want to track the air parcel, which is undergoing A to B to C, D, E, F, and all that. It will become very cluttered up. So we need a better diagram. So they developed this skew T, that is skewed temperature and lawn of pressure chart. Okay, let's go to the skew T lawn P chart, which will be the do or die chart for you in this course. Okay, yes. QT ln P chart. Skewed means it is inclined. Generally biased towards the side. Skewed, right? Okay. Now the abscissa is abscissa x equal to t plus constant into y. Okay, x and y are the two coordinates. X is the abscissa and y is the ordinate. Okay, now I am telling you y is minus ln p. Okay, so x equal to t minus constant into ln p. Equation number 1, y is equal to ln p is equation number 2, t minus constant okay. So actually y is like, you can also say that y is equal to x minus t by constant, that is minus ln p, correct? For an isotherm, t is constant. Therefore, y is equal to mx plus c. So where m is the same for all isotherms, c is different for different temperatures. This c, right? That is T by C. Okay. So isotherms are straight parallel lines. On a QT ln P chart, isotherms are straight parallel lines that slope upward from left to right. Okay, sorry. Isotherms on this QT are then, I need to show you this. How to get the other file? Show desktop, Yes. Yes, sir. I want this to be in full page, not this. You can crop this. Can you?
No, you want it be big.
No, I want only this to be shown on the screen.
Yes, sir. Then you have to use that, sir.
Zoom.
This is the page size only, sir.
Ah.
No, and the page size
only. Okay, I'll manage with this. Okay, you go back.
Just choose this.
You've stopped the recording now? Okay. Okay, so this is the QT log P or ln P chart. Okay, the isotherms in the pseudo adiabatic chart, the isotherms and the isobars are perpendicular to each other, but the pressure was logarithmic. Okay, here also the pressure is logarithmic. Bottom you have high pressure, top you have low pressure. Can you see the pressure? 1800. Okay. Okay, no, you cannot see. I will give you the chart, but it is already 1046. Tomorrow's class we will see. Anyway, now you believe me. Okay. So the pressure is all horizontal lines. The temperature should be vertical lines, but they are inclined at 45 degrees. So that is why it is called as QT ln P chart. What is the advantage of this QT ln P chart? Basically, it spreads out so that you got a good area to work with and solve problems. Instead of these isotherms and theta, constant theta lines getting cluttered up, you get some more working space for this. Now, problem number 25. Problem number 25. How does a dry adiabat or a pseudo adiabat, how does a dry adiabat or a pseudo adiabat look on a QT ln P chart? Problem number 25, how does a dry adiabat or a pseudo adiabat, that is constant theta line, look on a QT ln P chart? You are already able to see that, no? You cannot see that from there. Okay. Quick. We'll finish it. I'll just tell you this and so what is the equation for this? P. So for constant theta, agreed? I just use the Poisson equation, take log on both sides, and then I say ln P equal to constant, theta is a constant, ln T into constant plus some constant, okay. Plus constant is coming? Yes. If the new chart at the coordinates ln P and ln T, then dry adiabat would be a straight line. Watch my arguments very carefully. If on this QT ln P chart, both the temperature and the pressure were to be natural log, the dry adiabat, the equation of a dry adiabat is straight line, it will be a straight line. But whereas the pressure is ln of P, the temperature is not ln of T. Therefore, constant theta lines will be curved downwards. The constant theta lines will be curved downwards in a QT ln P chart, while they were straight lines pointing downwards in the pseudo adiabatic chart. Okay. So, just hang on for 2 more minutes. I will not take attendance. You go to the next class, right? Yes. So, but I will just draw this and then leave. 1000. Isotherms are straight lines, but skewed, okay. Okay. Skew T ln P chart. I come again. Skew T ln P chart, a very important quantity theta is sloping downwards. Then we will introduce one more quantity called saturated adiabat. So, which is not the pseudo adiabat, which is the actual adiabat for a moist air.